If you ever wondered, how can I make my workflow with Blender faster? One of the best ways that I can recommend doing that would be with the command line interface and using Blender from the command line. Let me show you the basics to help you get started on how to go about doing that. First, we need to just open up a terminal. With Windows, you can just search Command Prompt, and that should be the top result. Now, ideally, Command Prompt should be the default. For Windows 11, it does default to PowerShell. If that's the case, then just click this little drop-down arrow at the top and make sure you select Command Prompt. PowerShell has its own programming language, so sometimes it gets confused. So usually it's better to just use Command Prompt. Now let's try running Blender from the command line. Now you can just type in the file path to your Blender executable manually and it will run. You can use Tab to autocomplete when you type, but I learned just from this recording that you can actually drag and drop into Windows Command Prompt. So you can just drag and drop the Blender executable, and that will bring up the startup file for Blender. Now, after the Blender executable, if you add a space and then drag and drop the blend file that you want to run, it'll open Blender to that file. Now let's run Blender without the user interface. Now, between the Blender executable and the blend file, if you add a hyphen B, that is what is called a flag. In this case, the B is standing for background. You can actually look up all these flags on the Blender manual, which I'll link in the description as well. Now this will enable you to run Blender in the background, i.e. without the interface. Now you'll notice that it opens the file, but then it doesn't do anything and just quits. What if we want it to render? So let's have it render a still frame. So there's another command line argument. You do the dash F and then give the frame number that we want to render. It won't use the saved frame. You have to specify the frame. And you can see it gives all the render statistics and it renders and saves to a file. You can view the file at the default render file path that you gave in the blend file. Now, if you want to do a render for your whole animation, if we look at the manual, the argument is dash A, so you want to do dash A instead of dash F, and you can do just dash A by itself. If you wanted to override the frame start, for example, you can give the argument for frame start where you just give the flag frame start and then the value. Now you'll notice that in this example it still starts at frame 1, and if we look back at the manual, it'll say that actually the order of these parameters matters, that the dash A or dash F for the still frame animation should always be last. So just make sure that you always put those other parameters first. Now for fun, we can set the example for engine as well. You can see that it even gives a help option, so that way if you don't know, it'll just list the engine options that you have. And so in this case, we're gonna do Eevee, just for fun. And you can see that it renders an Eevee. The big questions are, what's the benefits of this? In terms of performance, the render times, this is probably going to be more helpful for users of lower end systems, especially users with less memory, because the benefit of rendering from the command line is that it can use less memory than you would by opening Blender and using Blender's user interface. Another option is to also run scripts in the background as well. So that way you can run Python scripts and change or evaluate your files without even opening up Blender's user interface. I actually use this in my BLint add-on for my escape short film that I did last year, which you can also watch on this channel. That I had a lot of files for all of the shots that I had, and BLint enabled me to be able to make corrections across all of my files without having to manually open up Blender and change each file. That includes the tutorial. This is just meant to be a beginner's tutorial, but if you ever want me to go over any other topics related to command line rendering or just using Blender with the command line interface, let me know in the comments. Thank you, and happy blending.